Speaking of IMDb, back in September and November 2014, you reached number one on IMDb, on the star meter, which means over more than 8 million people on the platform. You were the one person, Naomi Grossman, the one person the most searched on that database, and you peaked twice to number one. I don't know if people realize how big of a deal this is. How did you feel personally, Naomi, when you saw that on your phone, on your computer?
I was pretty excited. I mean, I was trying not to think about it because, you know, the fact is, like, it's just a number. It's like it's the ultimate popularity contest. I was working on American Horror Story at the time, so I'm like surrounded by people with extremely, you know, low IMDb numbers. Low is a good thing, by the way, when it comes to that. You know, at the same time, part of me is trying to be like, cool, like this is no big deal. But yeah, it was a huge deal. I mean, I remember looking and, you know, it rolls over at midnight. And so I check at midnight, and it was kind of one of those funny things where it was right around that same time that like Renee Zellweger changed her face. And so, of course, I was like, damn her. I can't compete with that, you know, and then, you know, someone and die and I can't compete with that. And then, you know, but then sure enough, I got to number one.
It's also a ranking generated by the actual interests from people in the industry, mostly who are looking for you because you've done something. So usually people rank up IMDb when they have a big show. For example, I just looked like 10 minutes ago, the people right now in Falcon and the Winter Soldier are up in IMDb to the top five because of the show is trending right now. Did the fact that you rose up to number one twice, what did it change for you? Did it start some kind of a domino effect?